It is time to clean up and dry drill unit tests. Let's first remove all what is not necessary and add a simple comment and zoom our file. We want to test the format date method of the format date class, so let's import it and initialize it. Then let's assign actual results to the return of the function we want to test with the parameter 22022. Finally, let's use PHP unit assert same static method. It ensures that two given values are the same. The first parameter is the expected value. The format date method should return 20 February 2022. The second parameter is the actual result. And the third parameter is a message that will be displayed when the test fails. Date is in wrong format, for example. Now, let's run our test. And our test is green, so the method returned what we expected too. If we want to add more tests, we can copy and paste those lines and change the parameter. But wait, this will get quickly messy, and this is where the data provider can help. The data provider will provide our test with data. First, let us add the parameter we want the data provider to provide. In our case, actual input and expected output. The data provider is a function that is added to the annotation data provider. Let's add provide dates, a function that we will create together. Let's use our IDE to create the function body. The data provider should return three-dimensional array. The first dimension should contain a message that describes this data. The second dimension should contain the parameter names. But the order here what really matters, which means what comes first will be injected into our test function first. And the third dimension should contain the value. Let's change now the parameter of the format date method to use the actual input parameter that will be provided by our data provider. And let's change the hard-coded date to the expected output that is also provided by our provide dates, the data provider. And let's rerun our test. And voila, our test is still working and is equivalent to the previous way. Now let's be more effective and add more data entries into our data provider. January dataset and March dataset. And rerun our test. Oh, our test has failed. And specifically the January dataset. I must improve my English because there is no January in English. It is January. Let's correct it and rerun our test. And yes, our tests are green and the method we are testing seems to be working as expected with different dates. Later we will be testing more effectively. But now, one more thing we can still do here. Imagine that we have more test methods in this class. We will be initializing the format date class on every method. Therefore, to prevent duplication, we can override the setup method from the test case. That will help us to set properties before our test run, and those properties can be accessed later from our test. So let's override the test case setup method and assign the format date instance to this formatter, a protected property that we will create together. And let's rerun our test. And voila, ladies and gentlemen, this was how to unit test using data provider and the setup method to test multiple scenarios. In the next video, we will find really issue of the format date method that we need to fix. And we will see why and how unit tests can help us and our teams save a lot of time. Thank you for watching and see you next time.